Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. So this is part two of my Windows PC build. If you haven't seen any of the previous videos, basically what this series is me building my very first Windows, and I'm gonna run Linux on it as well, but my very first computer. I never built a computer before. I am brand new to all of this. As of about a year ago, I didn't even know what a motherboard was, but for the last year, I've been trying to learn and whatnot, and it finally got to the point where I was like, if I wanna keep learning, I need to actually dive in and build a computer. Last video, we worked on the motherboard. I put the CPU cooler on, the RAM in, the NVMe SSD in, and now we're at the point where I'm gonna start working with the case and putting stuff in the case. So let's hop right into it. Now the first thing is with my case, I've read a lot of reviews that actually getting the actual fans for the case in there is a little bit on the tricky side, and that you almost have to take the entire case apart to do that. So before I even put the motherboard in, I'm gonna work on installing the fans into the case. Now I have six total fans, two sets of three. I'm gonna have three in the front and then three along the top. Welcome to my floor. So my case is quite large, so it's difficult. I can't really put this on the desk or put it underneath the overhead camera. But here is the case. So again, I showed in my unboxing video, but these are the fans that I got. I got a PC cooler, it does have RGB in it. It's just a set of three, and then I ended up getting two of those. So here are the fans. When it comes to knowing which direction the airflow flows, you can, number one, look for arrows on the fans to see which direction the airflow is. These don't have that, which is okay. The other way you can do that is look at the fans themselves. So if they're of this design, where it's almost like a kind of like a fan blade that is almost kind of dipping down like a spoon, the side that dips down, that is gonna be the airflow out. So airflow is coming out this way. This is the outtake side. This is the intake side. So the, I believe it's called convex, or basically the underside of the spoon. That is the intake, so air is flowing in this side, and it's flowing out this side. Now with my case, the design I'm going for is to have some intake fans on this front end, where the air is gonna come in, and then this is an open case that has two glass panels on each side, but the back is open over here, but I'm gonna have air coming in and going out that side. I don't have anywhere to mount fans over here, but I do have places to mount fans right here. So I'm gonna have intake on this side. Since heat rises, I'm gonna then have outtake on this side. So three intake fans right here and three outtake fans right here. Now when it comes to my actual case, these are the screw holes for the fans, but I can't really get to them because of this design right here. So what I'm gonna have to do is I'm gonna have to take apart pretty much the whole case, I believe, and then install the fans, and then put the case back together. Okie dokie, that covers it for the fans. That was actually easier than I expected. So as you can see, we got three fans up top here. These are all blowing air out. Awesome. And then we got three fans up front here, which are all taking air in. This is the first time I've ever built a PC, but this seems like a very well cooled machine. Let's put all of the cases, stuff, and everything back together. Okay, so I'm back on my desk. I was able to make a little bit of space for the PC case. So now what it's time for is to install the actual motherboard. In my PC case box, I had the screws for installing the motherboard. And at first I was confused because I thought the screws should be with the motherboard, but obviously that's not the case because the case is what has the actual screw holes and it might vary per motherboard. So here I've got my screws for the motherboard. One thing to note that I was not aware of is that these little spacers in here, these are very important when it comes to the motherboard because number one, it separates the motherboard from the actual case itself to protect it from like rubbing against it. But then the other thing it does is it, since this is metal, it allows basically a grounding point. So if there's a charge that goes through the motherboard, it will go through these instead of affecting the actual system. So that's kind of cool. So let's start installing this motherboard. Now, one thing that we want to be concerned about is the spacers scraping the underside of the motherboard. So as you can see, there's lots of spacers here. We want to make sure each of these lines up with an actual hole or the motherboard isn't over it. Because if it isn't over it, then it doesn't matter. But we want to make sure that this lines up with a hole. So again, this is my rear of the case. And we've got quite a few spacers, so I'm just going to focus on this for a minute. Okay, so we laid it flat, and all of my spacers are lining up with my motherboard, which is exactly what we want. So now we're just going to start the screwing in here. I'm making sure the screws are tight, but I'm not overwhelmingly tightening them. I'm going to the point where there it's like starts to say that it's tight, and then I'm doing a little bit more of a turn. And this gives me a new appreciation for screwdrivers with magnetic tipped pieces right here, because then you don't have to actually hold the screw on it. Okay, the motherboard is officially installed into my case. This is a big achievement, people, for me. I'm very happy. Now that we've got the motherboard installed, it is time to install all the various miscellaneous other connectors. So first off, all my fans here all have Molex connectors. So for those, I'm gonna have to connect to the actual power supply, I believe. Here's the antennas for Wi-Fi 6E. Those could go right here. However, since that is such an easy connector, I can do that at the very end of my build and it's not gonna be a problem at all. But if I install it now, there's gonna be these big dangly things sticking out which could potentially just get in the way. So I'm not gonna install that just yet. For some of these other connectors, let's look around and see here. So all my case connectors, I just attached here so they wouldn't get put elsewhere. So this is gonna be the USB connector. Now I've heard that this one's a little bit of a pain to connect, that's USB 3, but it goes right here. The reason you know that is because you have the notch right up here in the top. I don't know if you can see that well, but you have a notch right here and you have a notch right there. And then when you look at this, the bottom, if you're looking at it, the bottom right pin is taken out. So if I turn it this way, it's the bottom left pin. And if we look at this, the bottom left pin is out. Now, when it comes to this connector, what I've heard is that it's very fragile. So you wanna make sure that you have it positioned just right before putting pressure. So I'm not gonna actually put that one in just yet. Some of the other connectors is this one right here. We've got the power and the hard drive LED. And then I've got this, which I don't know what this is, but it is the same thing where you've got three and then one blank pin. So I imagine it would go right here. You know, I'm actually happy with it coming out of this hole. That's relatively clean. So again, we wanna make sure the USB 3, we wanna make sure the notch is at the top, and the very bottom right, if you're looking at it, is blacked out, which is the same as here. Okay, that went in easier than I thought. You hear a nice satisfying click, good. HD audio. So this connection has the second from the right blacked out or non-existent. Ah, this says audio over to the bottom left over here. So I think it is this connection right down here, but let's just take a look and see if there's any others here. Okay, and I do not see any others. So we are going to put that one right on over there. Okay, audio is connected. Next up, we have got this connection, which again is just that connection of the three pins with one in the middle that's missing. There's one right here just like that, just like the same thing that I used for my CPU cooler for whatever the other part is. I don't know if that's the fan or what is going on there, but we're going to apply that one right here. Okay, that's been applied. And then lastly, we have these case connectors. You know, I'm not sure about this one, so I am going to turn the camera off and consult the manual. Okay, I am back. So when I looked at the documentation for the motherboard, they said that the HDD and the power simply went right here under, you can't see it on camera, but it's labeled JFP1. So I just quite simply installed both of those right there on top of each other. In the motherboard manual, it gives directions about which side is positive and which side is negative. And then on the actual connectors themselves, they do document, or they do have a little plus sign and a minus sign so you know which one is which. So I just quite simply installed those right there. So that's that. We need to do something with these excessive cords here. In terms of cord organization, there unfortunately is not much I can do at this point. After I have a better idea, I'm gonna look at this again and perhaps reroute some of these wires. But for now, I wanna see what the big picture looks like. So it's time to install the power supply. Now again, this is the power supply that I got, the Corsair RM850 series. So we're gonna go ahead and remove the sticker. Now on the back of this connector, I don't know if I, to be honest, have enough connections. I've got SATA, PETA, I've got PCIe, I've got the motherboard connections, and I got more SATA, PETA, PCIe, and the CPU. But I don't have anything for Molex, I don't think, which I think all my fans are Molex, so I may have to redo all of that. We'll see. This is going to connect down here. So my screws are not in the appropriate places for this to screw in. Well, actually, that's because I did this all wrong. That's why. Let's take this back out. The way this needs to be is the connectors need to be on the back side over here. I was putting the cord here on the back side. So let's try this again. However, if I do that, then I don't have any screws on the back here. I have these. Maybe I did do that correctly. I don't know. I definitely want, I think what I did was, so, okay, this needs to be the plug-in. I need to make sure I don't drop this on the motherboard. This is the plug-in. It needs to be in the back. All the connectors are coming from here. I put it in this way. I think I want the fan on the bottom. This fan is curved. They're going like that. So that means that this is an intake fan, I think. I think I want it like this. The screws align, so I think we are in business. Also, with that, we're a bunch of cords, but I don't see any screws. So I think my screws must be with the motherboard. And yes, that does appear to be the case. In my motherboard, I have a little bag called power screws. Let's grab these out and start installing them. Hello, we're going back to the ground. Now, provided with the power supply was obviously this connector, which is going to connect into the back here and then plug into the wall. That's an easy connection. With the power supply, we had tons and tons and tons of other connections. So let's start going through these and figure out what we need to connect. The most obvious one is the actual ATX power connector. So the way you know it's this one is because this is the 24-pin connection. And as we can see here, we do have 24 pins on there. That divides into two connections. The 24-pin connection, I know, connects to the actual motherboard. And we know that because of the notch at the top up here. I think that's connected. This is a little bit more of a difficult connection to get in. It doesn't seem to click or anything. And then when you're pushing really hard, it almost seems like this, like there's the worry that you're going to bend the motherboard itself. I saw a review that said to provide some support on the motherboard, which is definitely a good idea. Let's see, we want to go through here somehow. This is a bit of a tricky connection because this is such a large case. To get down here takes quite a bit of space. But on the other end, so we've got 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16. We've got an 18 connection that plugs into the power supply. Now the other connection is 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. This is looped down now. We just have to get it into the actual hole. Okay, so I've had it on the floor for quite some time. I've been playing around. Here's what I've gotten. So I got the I've got the 24-pin ATX connector plugged in, as well as the second connector, I guess, which it required. Then underneath it, you can't really see it anymore. But over there, I got the CPU connector. There were two attached to that one as well. So those roll in through the back and then come up here. It splits. It has an 8-pin, but then it has a split thing where it's 4 and 4, so I had to take off 2 because the other connector in there was just a 4-pin, so 8 and then 4. And then again, the ATX, so those go up here. Then this one, so remember I was talking about how the fans, I wasn't sure how all those Molex plugs were going to plug in. So that one I plugged in here. I hope that's the right spot. It fits. And then over here in the back, I'm still working on the cable management, but here I daisy chained them, and then that connector actually had a total of 4 Molex plugs. So I am daisy chaining 6 of them. Hopefully that's all right. And then I tried a little bit on the cable management, still need to work on that end because it looks terrible at the moment. And then if you remember, these connectors for the USB as well as the case connectors were originally coming down from here. I decided I'm going to save this section just purely for the power supply connectors. And then I put them through here. And then I also added this one, which is originally from there as well. I added this one and brought it down from that hole. So it's been a long day. I will come back tomorrow and continue working. We're going to plug in the GPU for the last bit, I think. Hello, so it is the next day now. So between yesterday and today, I did a little bit of refining over here. So on the case, which I've got on the desk now. So number one, I rerouted some cables. If you remember when I installed the CPU cooler, I had them just sort of sitting down here. So I put those wires behind here so it hides behind the case and then they pop back out and come right there. I always thought that cleaning up the wires of a PC cable management, I always thought that cable management was relatively easy and I thought I'd be good at it. I have a massive amount of newfound respect for anyone that does computer cable management because it is incredibly difficult in my opinion, and my cables look awful, and this is after hours of trying to do cable management. Some other things with the case in here. So I have plugged in all my wires here. So basically, this took hours, oddly enough, but it took hours to figure out what needed to go in there and to try to route them through the back and whatnot. So I've got the ATX 24-pin connector, and then I've got a secondary connector in there. And then all these fans had Molex connectors, which I also rerouted because originally they were going down through here, but there were wires showing. So I rerouted the top three up here down through this hole in the top. And then I rerouted these ones through whatever holes were closest. So it was a little bit cleaner. Still looks terrible on the back. But all of these fans have Molex connectors. In my power supply case, I did find a connector with a ton of different Molex connectors attached to it. I think it had 4 or 5 Molex connectors attached. I don't really know where that plugs in the power supply unit. It fits in this little slot here that says SATA, and I'm going with it. So hopefully that works. I couldn't find anything online, so I think that's the right spot. The only thing with the actual fans that's left, is that they are RGB. Now, each of those fans, along with the 6 connectors for the Molex, they also have 6 3-pin connectors, which I think is for the RGB controller or something. So I'm not sure if my RGB is going to actually work or not, or maybe I just can't control it. But we'll figure that out later. I may need to buy a separate RGB controller. From a video, it seems like that's something that you need to plug that into, And if I need to do that, then I'll do that. But for now, we're going with this. Now we are at the part of the video where I'm going to install the GPU. So a couple things to note here with the GPU. First off is that the GPU is going to plug into the x16 PCIe slot. And my GPU has two 8-pin connectors on the outside of it. So in my CPU bag, I did have two PCIe connectors. Each of these are 8 pins. So I connected each of these 8 pins into the back, ran them around, and here they are. Here's one, here's two. Something else to note when it comes to the power supply or the PCIe cords here is that if you look at these, this is one cord. It comes out and then it splits into two. So on my GPU, I have got two 8-pin connectors. And so I originally thought, well, I'll plug this into one 8-pin connector, and then I'll plug this other one into the other 8-pin connector, and that covers it. And I've seen a lot of people online actually do this, but apparently this is not a good idea because each of these PCIe slots on the power supply, apparently the 8 pins only supply 150 watts of power. And then it's getting the PCIe connection itself from the motherboard, I believe, is getting 75 watts. So 150 plus 75 is only going to be 225 watts. My GPU is a 3070 Ti. It says the max draw could be 290. So that is obviously not enough. Now, when you plug these two ends, it's still only plugged into one connector on the power supply unit. So from my understanding and my research, that isn't a very good idea, which is very irritating because this is how the cord comes from the actual GPU, or sorry, the actual power supply unit manufacturers. It comes split, so it implies that you can split the cords. But apparently that's not a good idea. If anyone out there has any input on this or have recommendations, or if you guys disagree or if you guys know more than me, tell me. So to play this safe, I have plugged in two PCIe connectors into my power supply unit here. I've got them both routed through the back, and then I'm gonna plug each of these into one slot and just leave the split end, I guess, just dangling off. So we've gotten to the part that some people might consider as the most exciting, is I am gonna go ahead and install the GPU now. So my motherboard says that it has two by 16 PCIe slots and two by one PCIe slots. So this and this is obviously the one. That means that this and this obviously both have to be the by 16. So I'm actually gonna install the GPU in this one. And then in the future, when I install another M.2, if I decide to do so, I'm gonna have to likely disconnect that to put that there. But let's go ahead and do that now. So for my GPU, I went with the NVIDIA 3070 Ti. The brand I got was Zotac. I went ahead and removed the cover here that was on the PCIe slot. We're just gonna go ahead and drop this in. So now you can see that there's some screws right here. So we are gonna go ahead and screw those guys in. So I went ahead and found some screws in my case and screwed those two in so it's a little bit more secure. I will go ahead and peel this off. There's the colors. And then now I'm gonna go ahead and put this back on the floor and plug these PCIe cords into each of these slots here. So I'm back here on the floor. So over here I have again taken out I routed them through the back, and then we have one coming out here and it plugs into this one. We have another one coming up down through that hole, plugs into this one. I tried to cable manage the parts that split off as best I can by just using some zip ties here, which they look basically okay. They're just a little bit bigger than normal. So at this point, I am gonna finish up a couple little things. I'm gonna add in a couple poles that I had taken off to access the power supply area. And then I think we are ready to start testing this out and seeing if it actually functions. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that. I'm gonna put this case back together. I'm gonna put the sides on, which some people may say don't put the sides on yet if you don't know if it works, but I kinda want to. So I'm gonna put the sides on, make everything look good, and then we're gonna go from there. Okay, that is it. Everything is installed. Now that everything is done, I am getting really, I mean, I always was excited, but this has been a lot of work. Like, I know in this video it seemed like everything probably came together relatively quickly and easily, but it has been probably, I don't know, going on like maybe 12 hours of nonstop work towards this thing. So I'm really happy, and I'm really happy with the result. So here's what it is with the case on, but it actually looks relatively clean. It doesn't look like an absolute disaster. For my first build, I feel like it looks reasonably good. And then the other side, not the cleanest thing in the world. Now, eventually I'm probably gonna take this case off to add in some other stuff. In that case, I'll probably try to clean up this wire or make it look a little bit more neat. But it's not terrible. It's not awful for my very first build. So what's next? Well, on the next video, I'm going to go ahead and hook up all the exterior components like the mouse and the keyboard. And then we're gonna start testing and see how this thing actually works and if it works, and then troubleshooting, because I imagine it will have some issues. So here we go. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe, consider subscribing. I appreciate you watching. Have a great rest of your day.